All right. Welcome to the Department of Comics. This is our second episode with your host, me, Corey, aka Coredger, with my friend Aaron, aka Boba. This is again our second recording we've done. On our first one, we kind of got in the weeds a little bit with Dr. Aphra number 7. And today, Aaron is going to raise the roof a little bit more with some exciting information that you're not going to find anywhere else other than here, because no one else is reporting this stuff. So, Aaron, let's get this thing started. Well, you were talking to me about Darth Vader number 25. What's going on with this issue?
So Darth Vader number 25, from the second volume, it's the one that Charles Soule wrote. This issue has a big Ahsoka Tano appearance in it. And the reason why is it is the first and only adult Ahsoka Tano appearance in comics. All the other appearances we have from the Dark Horse, from Clone Wars, those are all in that Clone Wars era when she's younger. Mace Windu number 5, that's also from the Clone Wars era. Forces of Destiny, that's from the Clone Wars era. Darth Vader number 14, that flashback is from the Clone Wars era. Age of Republic special, that's from the Clone Wars era. This is the first Rebels adult Ahsoka Tano and only adult Ahsoka Tano in the Star Wars canon and in comics period. And not only that, in the page where she's on, it is also the first time that she's named in canon. So in all these other issues, she only gets named in the Age of Republic special, but that came out in 2019. Darth Vader number 25 came out in 2018, ahead of that one, and she's not named as Ahsoka Tano. She's given her nickname. So in the panel, it's Ahsoka standing back to back with Anakin, and above Anakin it says Sky Guy, and then underneath Ahsoka it says Snips. And Snips is what Anakin called her in the Clone Wars, and Sky Guy is what she called Anakin in the Clone Wars. And it's Darth Vader having a flashback of this. And when you go to Age of Republic Special, that's the first time in canon comics that she's actually called Ahsoka Tano. But Darth Vader number 25 is the first time she's given any sort of name. In all the other ones, we just see her. Particularly in Marvel. So Forces of Destiny obviously goes into her name and discusses who she is when she's going around with Padme, but that's in IDW and it is still canon, but that's not Marvel. This is Marvel.
This is pretty significant too, because key collectors and other sources that people use, that information isn't there. This is kind of nowhere to be found. And as everyone knows, you know, key collectors and other sources kind of move the needle when it comes to comic value. Is this just something that they just don't know? Or is this just something that's kind of I'm trying to connect the dots here as to why this hasn't gotten out there or why this issue isn't blowing up everywhere right now.
Well, when it comes to Ahsoka, since Disney has kind of revamped what canon is, there's not been a lot of Ahsoka in comics and canon. And I mean, I guess generally there's not been a lot of Ahsoka in comics, period. So when the information started first coming out about Ahsoka being in comics, it was originally Age of Republic special. That's the one she's in. That's number one. Then it was Darth Vader number 14. She's in that one. That one's come out first. And I was one of the ones who was able to point out and push forward in press that actually Mace Windu number 5, which predates all the other ones, is her first canon appearance. Mace Windu number 5 came out December 27th of 2017. The next one was Forces of Destiny from IDW. That one came out January 24th of 2018. And then it goes down from there. So Mace Windu number 5 is technically her first canon appearance. You will find stuff like that on Key Collector. Darth Vader number 25 on Key Collector says nothing about Ahsoka even being in it, let alone that it's the first and only adult Ahsoka, and that it's the first time in a Marvel comic that she's given some sort of name.
So for our listeners that are looking to pick up a copy of Darth Vader 25, what do you think, based on the current market, is a good price that we can pick that up at?
So you can actually find the B cover, which is the Galactic Icons cover of this, and it's got C-3PO on it, and it's done by Rod Rice. You can actually find one of those for pretty much cover price. I saw one sell last week on a live show for $3, and it was in near mint shape, just because people have no idea about who's actually in this comic. The A cover is going a little bit higher than that. The A cover is kind of around that $10 to $12 point, but I still think that's a great price. So anywhere between $10 to $20 for the A cover, I think, is a good price. Then there's a 1 in 25 that was done by Del Auto. There's a Del Auto 1 in 25. We all know how hot Del Auto is as an artist right now. And so just by the fact that this is the last of this series, it was a very good series. It's Del Auto. It's an incentive cover. The prices on those are higher. I've seen them $40 to $50 on eBay. Even at that, I would say go for that, because once the market gets wind of Ahsoka being in this, and it being the only adult Ahsoka in this, it could go up. And it wasn't even 6 months ago, Mace Windu number 5 was like a $5 or $10 comic. Now, yesterday I saw someone sell one on a live show for $140. Anything Ahsoka touches burns up. So you can almost guarantee that it's going to shoot once this gets out there.
So you're hearing it here first to our listeners. You want to get ahead of the curve and you're looking for value, pick up Darth Vader 25. As Aaron mentioned, the 1 in 25 incentive covers, because of the lower print runs, are usually the best or to grab, because, again, supply, demand, and there's smaller print runs. But the A cover, as well as the variant covers, I think will do well also. Was there anything else you wanted to discuss, or should we now switch to our next exciting topic of today?
We could go ahead and go to the next exciting topic. I'm excited to talk about this one too. It's more of we get to do some more breaking news here with the Department of Comics.
All right. Well, I want to build you up a little bit here and have you go nuts with it. So last week we discussed Dr. Aphra number 7. You want to expand on that and give our listeners some information on Bounty Hunters number 9. And buckle up, ladies and gents, because here's another money-making opportunity for you.
Yeah, so Dr. Aphra number 7 came out last week, reported as having a first appearance of Wendelfus. That's true. Wendelfus is in it. Key Collector did report that it had a first appearance of Wendelfus, and because it is a Star Wars book with a first appearance, it went crazy right off release. A covers yesterday, an A cover sold on eBay for $12. It's gone to a second print now, and I want to kind of break down this first appearance and compare it to the first appearance we have in Bounty Hunters number 9 this week. And you won't find Bounty Hunters number 9 on Key Collector, because the whole book itself isn't even on there, let alone that these have first appearances in them. So in Dr. Aphra number 7, we have the first appearance of Wendelfus. I broke it down. You will find Wendelfus in 7 panels, and he has 9 speaking lines. 7 panels and 9 speaking lines. So that's driven a book from cover price to triple cover price because of 7 panels and 9 speaking lines. Bounty Hunters number 9, we have 2 first appearances in this one. We have the first appearance of Commander Hill Purpura, and then we have a first appearance of Private Blanche Sproul. Now, Commander Hill has 16 speaking lines and is in 10 panels. And then Private Sproul is in 9 panels with 11 speaking lines. So both of those are more influential to this issue than Wendelfus was to Dr. Aphra number 7. Yet, No one knows this. No, it's never been reported that these are first appearances, that these are important to this issue. And even moving forward, if you've read Dr. Aphra number 7, when Delphus is like a mastermind of a criminal organization, he's kind of like a shadow leader. He's not one that you're probably going to see a whole lot of. He's the kind of person who tells his goons to go do something, and then you follow his goons while they're going to do something. And then maybe at the end of the next issue, they come back and he's like, good job. So that's the kind of character Wendelphus is. These characters in Bounty Hunters are on the forefront of what is actually happening and are very important to this issue.
So last week, obviously, we talked about Dr. Aphra number 7. We went over which covers to buy. Let's talk about Bounty Hunters number 9. I know there is an A cover. What other covers are they? Are there? And what should our listeners look for?
So there's the A cover, which is an awesome cover, by the way. There is the Empire Strikes Back 40th Anniversary cover by Sprouse. That is also an awesome cover on that. And I think there might be a 1 in 25. I've not seen it, but I know that Marvel is doing 1 in 25s with almost everything that they do now. But I can tell you that I have seen both the Empire variant and the Bounty Hunters A cover are still going for cover price on eBay. I was just in a vintage stock yesterday, and they both had the A cover of Bounty Hunters, and they had one A cover of Dr. Aphra number 7 left. So the both of these issues are still out there, particularly Bounty Hunters. You can find them for a good price. It's just a matter of doing your hunting.
So for both these issues, Dr. Aphra number 7 and Bounty Hunters number 9, I'm thinking these are long-term holds, right? I don't think that this is something, maybe for the Dr. Aphra 7 last week, we were saying the 1 in 25 variant, that one is going for like 150 or so right now. That might be something people want to consider selling right away if they're not collectors. I would imagine with Bounty Hunters 9, since it's relatively new, this might be a good hold just to see how storylines develop and how these characters play out, or what do you think for the resellers that are listening right now?
So this is a hard one for Bounty Hunters number 9. And here's a bit of a backstory on this issue. So the reason why there's a first appearance in this one is the writer goes to a comic shop, and the owner of the comic shop, their last names are Hill and Purpura. And this is the comic shop that the writer's been going to for a long time. So to do a solid as a friend and make them canon within Star Wars, he wrote them into this character, and we have Commander Hill Purpura now. Based on that, I don't know if this is going to be a long-term character. Normally, when you see writers do something like that, they aren't typically very long-term characters. They're usually important to that arc, but then they kind of either get killed off or something else happens and they disappear. But I don't know if that being a long-term character. I also don't know if Private Sproul is going to be a long-term character. I can tell you that they are very important to what happens in this issue and is what is happening in this arc. After that, as comic readers and fans, we're all going to have to read it and find out.
Well, there you have it. We've got a bunch of great information shared today for people to be on the lookout for. I love that we're so far ahead of the curve with a lot of these things where people can actually get some real value and investments, whether you're collectors or resellers alike. Was there anything else you wanted to go over today, or you want us to wrap it up?
No, I think that pretty much covers everything.
All right. I want to thank you again, and I know our listeners love your input here. This is going to be our thing where we discuss either Star Wars, Marvel, DC, Image, or any independent. We're going to try to provide as much information to our listeners as we can. If you like what you hear, please hit the subscribe button on the bottom and give us a like. You can follow us at the Department of Comics on Twitter, on Facebook, on Instagram, and we actually have the department, DEPT of comics.com website coming soon. You can also get a lot of great content on the Department of Comics Discord server, which we have a link on our YouTube channel for. So thank you all so much for listening and for your support. More to come.